British investors are getting on the Bitcoin bandwagon in a big way. The number and value of transactions has grown exponentially over the past year as people try to catch the wave and ride it to high valuations. But the recent collapse of two major cryptocurrency exchanges has rocked the industry, prompting the government to step in to protect investors. Paolo Montesilio has more.
When Cem Yılmaz opened Turkey's first cryptocurrency counter in early 2018, the price of Bitcoin was hovering around $10,000. In 3 years, the world's premier blockchain token has surged sixfold, giving Nakit coins a big boost.
The growth in cryptocurrency, what we saw from 2018 till 2021, where we are right now, has been immense. I can say that over the last 6 months, if I would have to give you an educated guess, we grew in the number of transactions about 600%.
Bora Erdemar runs the research center Blockchain IST. He says as many as 4 million Turks hold investments in the sector. Data for April from tracking site CoinGecko shows people in the country have been buying and selling $2 billion worth of cryptocurrencies every day. That's more than double the level in March. It also exceeds the daily trading volume of $1.7 billion for local equities.
It looks like the popularity of the cryptocurrencies now exceeding the investment options in Istanbul Stock Exchange. So the number of users are also more than the users in Istanbul Stock Exchange, and these numbers are exponentially growing.
With more people exposed to the risks, the central bank has introduced regulations to ensure the stability of markets.
The central bank's new rules ban the use of cryptocurrencies to pay for any goods and services. It says the volatility of assets like Bitcoin could erode confidence in the financial system. Officials also worry criminals will use virtual money in ways authorities won't be able to track or prevent.
The need for supervision has never been more urgent. Two local trading platforms collapsed in April alone. The founder of Thodex has fled the country, allegedly with $2 billion in client funds. And police have arrested top officials at VeBitcoin, which shut down due to liquidity issues. In response, the central bank says it will also start regulating cryptocurrency exchanges.
Hopefully, that will also improve the existing and solid cryptocurrency exchanges and eliminate the scam ones, eliminate the dirty projects. So that is the hope.
But according to Erdemar, the best way to keep investors safe will be with better financial literacy. He says people who know what they're getting into and are confident the government has their back will feel better with the risks they take in pursuit of potentially massive rewards. Paolo Montesilio, TRT World, Istanbul.
Well, let's get more on this now with blockchain researcher Turan Sert in Istanbul. He's an advisor at the Blockchain IST Center hosted by Bahçeşehir University. He's also a board member of the Turkish cryptocurrency exchange Paribu. Welcome to the program, Tura. Firstly, tell us more about this boom in cryptocurrencies in Turkey. Who's buying them exactly and why are they flocking to cryptos in such a big way, and how big is the market now?
First of all, good afternoon, Oscar. Thank you for your invitation, and happy to answer all your questions. Well, looks like that the Turkish market has been. Turkey is one of the leading markets in Turkey in the world in terms of the cryptocurrencies, and I mean you can put out many different reasons why, but I think it generally suits to Turkish people in terms of like their risk appetite. Turkish people are very risk lovers, and that's probably one of the reasons why cryptocurrency is actually booming right now in Turkey.
Okay, now over the past week, we've seen at least four Turkish cryptocurrency platforms essentially disappear or go offline. These exchanges essentially buy and sell cryptocurrencies on behalf of local users. Can you tell us In that time, we know that many of them have simply stopped payment. They say that they have a liquidity problem. They simply don't have the money. How is that the case? Is it just bad management?
I believe most of it through bad management. And let me tell you why. Unfortunately, the cryptocurrency market in Turkey is not that, so far has not been regulated. And we have all been saying so up until now that a regulatory environment was necessary. And we see that the government has been, like any other government in the world, has been observing, trying to see what's going on, as this is a very dynamic market, a very technologically market. They were like kind of in the wait and see mode so far. But right now we have seen that the government authorities, the regulators are now trying to, starting the actions. We have seen that actually 2 weeks ago with the regulations that's coming out from the Central Bank of Turkey. And I believe this is one of the first steps in terms of the regulatory environment, and many more were to come over the next couple of months. Now, there are, we don't have the regulation, as we don't have the licenses right now, we do not know how many cryptocurrency exchanges in Turkey right now, but the estimates range from close to 100. And most of those cryptocurrency exchanges are kind of like mom and pop shops. And that's why actually you have seen such cases as we have seen right now. There are different kind, I mean, the of those cases that we have seen over the last week or two, one is a major, sort of major exchange. And what we have heard, and again, this is speculation, so we don't know for sure, but they had apparently been subject to cyber attacks a couple of years ago. And when they had that, they lost some of their customers' cryptocurrencies. And they acted as if nothing happened. And as there were no regulation, they kept going on and on. But when the government decided to take to put the regulation in place, I believe they thought, well, you know, so long. It's not possible anymore to continue like that, and they decided to shut down their business.
Which, and can I think, ask as you, I said, Turan, which sure. company are you talking about? Is this Thodex?
Yes, exactly.
Thodex. Okay. Can I ask you more about the collapse of that Turkish exchange, Thodex, last week? Because we know it made sure. international headlines and even sparked a manhunt for its CEO, Faruk Fatih Özer, who, as we know, fled overseas. Reports also suggest that he may have fled with around $2 billion worth of users' money. You gave us some really good insight in that case. So you're saying that you're hearing that perhaps they were the victim of a hack and they actually lost users' cryptocurrencies. What more do we know about it? Are users likely to be able to access their money again at some later date?
Well, we do not know that for sure, but let me tell you this for sure. $2 billion is definitely an overstated number. All those experts in the cryptocurrency industry know that $2 billion is way overstated. I mean, and this is, unfortunately, someone made a very back of the envelope calculation and with wrong assumptions and came up that $2 billion number. There is no $2 billion. So far, many respected researchers in Turkey, such as Tufan Poyraz and Aytunç Yıldızlı, have been trying to calculate the loss amount, and so far they have come up with $150 million figure, okay. $150 million. Now, that does not include the Bitcoin numbers, but cryptocurrencies other than Bitcoin. So the right. number may be a bit higher than $150 million, but it's definitely not $2 billion. That's way too much, and that's, I think, a miscalculation.
Okay. Can so I ask you now... Sorry to interrupt you again, but can I ask you quickly before we go about this question of regulation? As you say, the Turkish Central Bank earlier this month basically banned the use of cryptocurrencies to buy actual goods and services. And we also know the Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan has warned that this crypto market could risk creating so-called pyramid schemes that would essentially rid innocent people of their money. So what sort of regulation do you believe needs to happen in this country in that market?
Well, I think and I believe government authorities right now are working intensely to come up to create a regulation that would prevent small investors. And I think that's the right way to look at it. We do need to make sure that the small investors' money is in safe hands. And for that sense, I think the regulation should focus on cryptocurrency exchanges and the deposits, the custody that they have. I mean, the digital assets that they have under custody should be intact, and they should not be able to, especially the fiat currency, Turkish lira, money that the small investors send to cryptocurrency exchanges should be held under Turkish banks, the Turkish lira. So that's, I think, one of the part of the regulation that has to be in place. The second piece is the government should put in enough regulation and control to make sure that the cryptocurrency exchanges have full amount of what the their customers hold in themselves in terms of the cryptocurrencies. I think that should be the focus of the regulation so far. And look, cryptocurrencies and blockchain technologies are up and coming new technologies. And they are right now in development phase. They are not mature at the moment. And as they are not maturing at the moment, it's really difficult to determine the price and the value of the cryptocurrencies and the underlying technologies.
Yes.
But as we move forward over the next couple of years, we will be better. We will be able to better understand the dynamics, okay. And it will be like a growing area.
Yes.
So right now, it's in a very speculative mode, and that's why we see ups and downs in the cryptocurrencies.
Okay, Turan Sir, I'm afraid we'll have to leave it there, but thank you again for joining us from the Blockchain IST Center and Paribu. We appreciate it.